Hi everybody, this is Dr. A. This is the first video in a series that's going to be about just basics of the lab. So we're going to do an introduction to the clinical lab setting and answer the question, what is a clinical laboratory? Okay, so a clinical laboratory is a facility where diagnostic or screening tests are performed on a patient's body fluids and or tissues. And this is to assist a healthcare team in the diagnosis, treatment, and prevention of disease. So there you go, now some pretty definition. They are often found in modern hospitals and reference laboratories, and they usually have big pieces of equipment and lots of chemicals, lots of reagents, lots of things going on. They are typically not open to the public, so you can't just wander into your average clinical lab and look at all their equipment, etc. Some of them you may come into the like outpatient draw area and get some samples drawn maybe in a big clinic or in a big hospital. But the public is definitely not allowed back there to where all the analyzers and tech are. So the most common places you will find clinical laboratories are going to be in the hospital. So it'll be a centralized location within the hospital where all the testing takes place. In some hospitals, if they're really big, it might even be spread over a couple of floors. So it just depends on the size of the hospital. It could be a reference lab. So reference labs are usually independent structures, freestanding. They're off-site facilities. They perform more complex testing and they perform a high volume of tests, usually drawing samples from an entire region, several states. So they draw lots, you know, there's samples that are coming in from everywhere. And so they can do more specialized testing, tests that is not really feasible for maybe a hospital lab to have because they just don't do enough of them. But in a centralized location like a reference lab, since they draw from a bigger geographical area, then they can afford to do them and they can do them at a good price. And then a lot of physician offices and clinics will have a lab. And so they usually do more simple testing. They're located in, you know, the clinic or the physician's office to perform tests on the patient to get the results right then. And so they will do, you know, very basic testing, things where you might want to know the answer right then. For example, you do a strep test or a flu test, or, you know, quickly check a blood sugar or things like that, that it helps for the physician to have the information right away to make treatment and diagnostic decisions on their patients. So which departments are in the clinical laboratory? So the clinical laboratory is broken up into departments, often referred to as benches. It just kind of depends on where you're located. But the first one is going to be hematology. So this is where we do a lot of the blood counts, look at the cellular components of blood. The next one is coagulation, also referred to as hemostasis. So this is where we check the clotting factors and how well the blood clots, and, you know, so how thin the blood is. Sometimes it's referred to as that. If somebody's on blood thinners, can check how those are working for them. We can also check coagulation status before they go to surgery to make sure they're not going to bleed out. Next is the urinalysis bench. That one's kind of self-explanatory. On that one, we do a lot of analysis of urines. And oftentimes, other little tests can be done on that bench, things like pregnancy tests and maybe some strep screens or flu swabs. Then we have clinical chemistry. So this is where there's usually big analyzers and lots of testing going on the chemical components of blood. So electrolytes, sugar, lots of enzymes, etc. Then we have the immunohematology, also known as blood bank and transfusion services. So this is where blood samples will go to get typed, see if you're type A, type B, AB, or O. And what Rh, and then if there's potentially needed blood for transfusion, you know, for surgery or something like that, then the tech spec there will get those ready. Immunology and serology. So sometimes, depending on the size of the lab, that's its own department. Sometimes immunology and serology is kind of just folded in with other departments. So this is where we do a lot of antibody antigen testing. So like I was referring to, you know, the flu swabs and the strep screens and all of that, which sometimes I'll done in on another bench if you have an immunology serology kind of bench, and you can do it on that bench. Doing things like testing for C. diff, the, you know, for example, some of the COVID testing might be done there, although some of them are done by PCR, and that would be molecular diagnostics. But if they're doing the quick antigen test, that's an immunology serology test. And then we have the microbiology department, which is where all the cultures are sent to grow the different bacteria, pathogens, identify bacteria, fungi, viruses, etc., that are infecting the patient on various types of body fluids. And then we have molecular diagnostics. So this is more of all the genetics testing. And there's more and more that's being done now with molecular diagnostics. So the COVID PCR test would definitely be a molecular diagnostic test. But there are a lot of newer, fancier tests that are in this realm that are very helpful. A lot of them to diagnose, to help the microbiology department diagnose infections. And then point-of-care testing is also, it's kind of a bench, not really. I mean, it's the one that's out of the lab, because point-of-care means at the bedside. And so this is a testing that is done usually at the bedside, often by the nursing staff. So again, what is tested in each department? Hematology is blood in all its formed elements. So we're going to more specifically look at white cells, red cells, platelets, the type of white cells that are present, often do blood smears, look at them under the microscope. The analyzer is going to count the amount of white cells and red cells, the amount of hemoglobin, the amount of platelets, and all that in the sample. Coagulation, again, we're assessed the bleeding and clotting problems, and that is often done either to assess treatment with blood thinners for patients or to assess risk of bleeding before surgery. Urinalysis is going to be physical, chemical, and microscopic examination of urine. So we look at it, color, clarity, cloudiness, all of that. We do the little dipstick. So that's a chemical analysis, and it checks, you know, pH, specific gravity, is there sugar in there, are there ketones in there, etc. And then microscopic examination, we do put it under the microscope, spin it down some, and then put it under the microscope and look to see, do you see bacteria, do you see white cells, red cells, etc. The chemistry, again, there's lots of tests in there, and we can test a variety of body fluids. We tend to test mostly serum and plasma, but we can test spinal fluid and, you know, peritoneal fluids and other things. And we look for, you know, chemical substances that are normally present there. So lipids, proteins, electrolytes, glucose, enzymes, hormones, all things, and just check to see if the levels of those are appropriate. In toxicology, which is, can be a department of its own, or it can be folded in with clinical chemistry. But in that one, more specifically, you test for recreational drugs, illegal drugs, and pharmaceutical drugs. And some of the pharmaceutical drugs obviously can be things that people are prescribed. So if somebody's on seizure medications and they're having some seizures, we can check the level of those medications in the blood to see if maybe the patient's taking too much or not enough of their seizure medicine. Immunohematology is also known as blood bank. So this one obviously determines blood groups and performs compatibility testing on blood donors and recipients to make sure that the blood matches the recipient so that there's no reaction. And the staff can also prepare blood components, blood derivatives, and products for transfusion. So we're thinking of packed red cells, we're thinking fresh frozen plasma, cryoprecipitate, and all of these things to make sure that's we give the right type of product to the patient and it's properly matched, it's going to be as safe as possible for that patient. And then immunology serology, so it uses all the concepts of antigen-antibody interactions as a diagnostic tool. You can look for the antigens or you can look for the antibodies, it just depends on the test. And immunology and serology can also be used to determine organ or tissue compatibility. There's a lot of tests that can fall under immunology and serology, from your average pregnancy test to your COVID antigen test to, again, strep screens, RSV screens, flu swabs, but then checking for antibodies to hepatitis B, antibodies to HIV, all of that falls under immunology and serology. So microbiology receives almost any type of clinical specimen, including swabs, feces, sweat, sputum, spinal fluid, synovial fluid, as well as any type of infected tissue. And it helps identify disease-causing microorganisms. Then more specifically in the microbiology department, you can have parasitology. So they specifically look for parasites, so for worms, but also, flagellates, things like malaria. So parasites, a specific type of microorganisms. And then virology is a section of micro that's concerned with identification of viruses. And we don't really culture viruses. Viruses now are identified in two primary ways, either through serology antigen antibody testing or through PCR molecular diagnostics genetic testing. And then so molecular diagnostics does perform DNA and genetic testing. Again, the biggest application of molecular diagnostic in the clinical lab in your hospitals is going to be to identify the various microorganisms that might be infecting a patient. And then point of care testing, again, is done at the bedside, often by nursing staff. You can think of your echocheck glucose. Those can be done there. But there's even some more complex point of care testing, such as ABGs and other chemistries that can be done at the bedside, also during surgery by the OR staff. Then we also have cytopathology. So they examine smears of cells from all over the body for evidence of inflammation, cancer, and other condition. So cyto is cell, so cell pathology, right? And then histopathology looks at solid tissue, so often things that come from have been removed from the body via biopsies or surgical removal. So maybe if a tumor or mass has been removed, then they can be sent and sliced up and look at the microscopic level to get more specific information about the cancer or what's going on with that specific tissue. Surgical pathology examines the organs, limbs, tumors, fetuses, and other tissues that are biopsied in surgery. So breast tissue from mastectomies and stuff. So surgical path is oftentimes folded into with histopath and even cytopath, because what they do is kind of all related there and all goes together. And that is it. So that is your intro to the clinical lab.